Welcome to this morning's Remembrance Sunday commemoration. Obviously it's a very small scale thing this year because of the difficult circumstances in which we find ourselves, but even the biggest of this commemoration is much reduced in scale compared to the normal one. I'm sure I don't need to remind you, but just in case, because of the COVID-19 issues, please remain safely distanced from one another. Although we very much like to shake hands and so on, we avoid doing that today. And there isn't any singing to do. And if you want to hum along to the national anthem when we get to that point, please do. Right, it's a dreary day, and I guess perhaps creates its own sombre mood, which I guess is fitting on Remembrance Sunday, when we commemorate fallen in all conflicts. Remember those damaged, physically and mentally, the sacrifices made by so many military and civilian people, and if you like, the collateral damage done to the men, women and children caught up in war through no fault of their own. So we'll start our service with a few Bible verses.
God is our refuge and our strength. Very pleasant health in trouble.
I lift up my eyes to the hills. From whence will my help come? My help comes from the Lord, who made heaven and earth.
This I call to mind, and therefore I have hope. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning.
Those who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint.
What does the Lord require of you but to do justice and to love kindness and to walk humbly with your God?
Perhaps I could ask those who'd like to lay a wreath to come forward one at a time. Just give each other plenty of room and lay your wreath as you wish. Presence of God, we commit ourselves to work in penitence and faith for reconciliation between the nations, that all people may together live in freedom, justice and peace. We pray for all who in bereavement, disability and pain continue to suffer the consequences of fighting and terror. We remember with thanksgiving and sorrow those whose lives in world wars and conflicts, past and present, have been given, taken away,
are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn.
At the going down of the sun, and in the morning, we will remember them.
We will remember them.
Shall we have our 2 minute silence now? So our silence begins. Ever-living God, we remember those whom you have gathered from the storm of war into the peace of your presence. May that same peace calm our fears, bring justice to all peoples, and establish harmony among the nations. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
I leave with you. My peace I give you.
above is first pure, then peaceable, gentle, willing to yield, full of mercy and good fruits, without a trace of partiality or hypocrisy. And the harvest of righteousness is sown in peace for those who make peace.
This is the message we have heard from him and proclaim to you, that God is light, and in him there is no darkness at all.
So we'll have a short time of prayer. Let us pray for all who suffer as a result of conflict, and ask that God may give us peace. For the servicemen and women who have died in the violence of war, each one remembered by and known to God. May God give peace.
God give peace.
Those who love them in death and in life, offering the distress of our grief and the sadness of our loss. May God give peace.
God give peace. For all members of the armed forces who are in danger this day, remembering family, friends, and all who pray for their safe return. May God give peace.
God give peace.
For civilian women, children and men whose lives are disfigured by war or terror, calling to mind in penitence the anger and hatred of humanity. May God give peace.
God give peace.
For peacemakers and peacekeepers, seek to keep this world secure and free. May God give peace.
God give peace.
For all who bear the burden and privilege of leadership, political, military, and religious, asking for gifts of wisdom and resolve in the search for reconciliation and peace. May God give peace.
God give peace. O God of truth and justice, we hold before you those whose memory we cherish, and those whose names we will never know. Help us to lift our eyes above the torment of this broken world, and grant us the grace to pray for those who wish us harm. As we honour the past, may we put our faith in your future. For you are the source of life and hope, now and forever.
Amen.
And so we join together in the Lord's Prayer.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done. On earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
I'd just like to ask James to plant one more cross for peace in the world.
When you go home,
tell them of us and say,
for your tomorrow, we gain our today.
Merciful God, we offer to you the fears in us that have not yet been cast out by love. May we accept the hope you have placed in the hearts of all who love you and live lives of justice, courage, and faith. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Always.
Amen. So let us go.